Shift A, mesh, and add in a cube. I'm going to go into edit mode, scale this down, and move this roughly to where the shirt would be. Also go from the side view and adjust it appropriately. I'm going to add a loop cut here and another loop cut here. I'll toggle on the X-ray mode, select this vertex and bevel it with Ctrl B and press V to actually bevel the vertex. And I'll just select everything and move it roughly to where the neck is. I'll adjust these two front edge loops this way and the same for the back. I'll select this face and delete it. And you might have noticed we have created an end gun here and we don't want that. So I'll use the knife tool with K on the keyboard and cut a new edge here and cut another new edge here. We want to make sure everything we are doing on this side is mirrored over to this side. So with the auto mirror add-on enabled, I'll select auto mirror and it automatically adds a mirror modifier for us. I'm going to add another edge loop here. SZ0 to scale it on the Z axis. This part will be where we extrude the sleeves from, but before we do that, I'm going to select these two faces under here, X, and delete them. I'll select that edge, right click, and when the loop tools add-on enable the blender, I'll select circle. I'll scale this down and just move that into place. I'll also select this edge loop and do the same, loop tools, circle. Adjust these vertices to fit the character a bit more. I also select this edge loop, right click, loop tools, circle. And I'll just rotate this into place from the side view. I also adjust this vertex, bring it down a little bit. Push this one in like so. Now we're going to extrude this one more time downwards and scale it from the front view to fit your character. Also scale it from the side view, S, Y, and G to move it in place, S, Y, and G to move it in place. I'll select these two faces from the front view, E, and I'll extrude them out and just rotate it into place. I'll delete those two faces, select that edge loop, right click, loop tools, and choose circle. And I'll just adjust that into place. Now we want to add in more geometry to this mesh. I'll add in an edge loop here. I'll add in an edge loop here. One here, one here, one here, one here, one here, and one here. And now I want to fix the topology of this clothes. You don't have to do this, but I'll show you how I fix it. I'm going to add a loop cut here and just bring it close to this place. I'll select these two vertices M and mesh them at center. And I'll also do the same for the back. These two M are made at center. And now we can add a loop cut that goes all the way around the shirt. We can now dissolve these edges with Ctrl X. I'm going to add in a loop cut here and another loop cut here. Also add in another loop cut here. I'll select everything and right click smooth vertices. And now we'll go into the sculpt mode to further refine our shirt. I'm going to apply the mirror modifier and with the grab brush, make sure X symmetry is enabled and we're going to start pulling the shirt into shape. Holding down shift to smooth out the clothes. And also do the same for the back. And if any of your vertices is disconnected like this, you can just select them, M, and mesh them at center. I'll go back to sculpt mode and just keep on refining the shape to make sure it fits the character. And now we have something that looks like a basic shirt. I'm going to go to the object mode, Ctrl 1 to add a subdivision surface modifier, and I'm also adding a solidify modifier. I'll move the solidify above the subdivision and just change the thickness to about 0.05. I'm going to go back to sculpt mode and make sure nothing is intersecting with the body of the character. Now go into edit mode to further adjust this. I'll select this loop, right click, loop tools, and choose circle. You can right click in object mode and shade smooth. To get rid of this type of shading artifact, we're going to go into edit mode and just add in supporting edge loops around those corners. And add one right down here. And we also want to mirror what we have here on this side, so we can once again use the auto mirror and make sure the mirror modifier is above every other modifier. And in object mode, we can just apply it. I'm going to add in some extra edge loops here and use the auto mirror again to mirror it. And in object mode, apply the mirror modifier. With this simple technique that I've showed you, you can use it to create complex clothing like this. You can actually check my process for creating these types of clothes. I'll leave a link in the description where you can check that out. But before you go to check that out, I want to show you something that absolutely blew my mind when I figured it out in Blender. And that is how to add seams to your clothes. I'm going to go into edit mode and just add in a new edge loop here. Auto mirror to mirror what we have done. I'll apply that. I'll add in a new edge loop here and one down here. I'll select those edge loops I just added in. Ctrl E to bring up the edge menu and I'll just mark them as sharp. I'll add in an edge split modifier, move it above the solidify and subdivision, make sure to uncheck edge angle, and now we already have something that looks like seams. Under the solidify modifier, I'll bring down the edge data menu, I'll change crease inner to 1 and the rim to 1. And now we have something that looks like seams. If we want it to be more smooth, we can duplicate the subdivision surface modifier and move it above the edge split modifier. Make sure to go into sculpt mode and make sure nothing is intersecting with your character. And just like that, we have added seams to our clothes. Catch you guys in the next one.